Three-stitch trim is a simple way to finish necklines, armholes, and some other things when you don't want a whole lot of knitting at the edge. It's especially good for baby garments. This trim is really just stockinette. It's a special way of applying it. The two sides look very similar to each other. Cast on three stitches and knit one row. Here I'm using contrasting yarn in roughly the same weight and main stitch size. Hold the garment up to the machine with the wrong side in view. In this case, purl side is the right side, so we're looking at the knit side. This is an armhole, so we're beginning at the underarm right by the side seam. Push the tool through that spot near the edge of the fabric and hang it on the center needle. Now knit two rows. We repeat basically the same thing for the entire operation, but there are some subtle differences as we move around the armhole. Here at the underarm where stitches were bound off, I usually hang each stitch right behind the bind off, but in some sizes and yarns and projects, you want to occasionally hang the second stitch, not the first, to get the length of the trim to perfectly match the length of the underarm. Knit two rows every time something is hung. It's often easier to bring the needles forward and let them knit back from hold. And that being said, we'll just understand that there are always two rows knitted. I won't keep showing you those two rows. Here's the last of the bound off underarm stitches being hung. After two rows, we'll change slightly. This blouse represents the very common situation wherein we decrease one at the armhole every other row. So there is a slanted stitch showing where a decrease occurred. I did decrease right at the edge. Here are several views showing you what it looks like where the decrease occurred, and that's what we want to pick up every other row across the decreases. However, because we're making a diagonal line here, two rows plus a decrease is a little bit longer of a distance than two rows vertically. So to keep the trim from pulling in the arm too much, I turn it up one whole number. I was using stitch size 7, now stitch size 8, just for the decreased area of the work. Forgive the shakiness of this next bit. I wanted you to get to see it really up close, so I'm filming with one hand and hanging with the other hand, and it's less than perfection. Worked though. If there are any yarn tails in the area, make sure they come towards you so they stay on the wrong side of the trim and you can weave them in later. Here's another look at hanging those decreases. One is on the tool now, and the yellow arrow that showed it first was the next one that will be hung. With the decreased area complete, we now go back to the main stitch size. For this project, that is stitch size 7. From here on the vertical sweep of the armhole, we hang every other row right next to the outer column of stitches, so we'll skip a hole and hang a hole. I'm stretching the knitting out in rather abnormal ways so you can get a good look at the structure. But skip a row, hang a row, same pace as the knitting. Because we're knitting two rows between every incidence of hanging an area. Just to continue that until the armhole is complete and then bind off.